So the time has come to pull out the monster here. So when you look at this guitar, there's probably a few questions coming to the mind, right? Biggest question being, why? So this guitar, first of all, do you think this is just like for showing off? Well, it is. No, actually, funny enough, there are some reasons behind the construction of this guitar. And I would like to go through them with you. So there are three necks, as you can see, and there are also four cables coming out of it. And there's even a leg strap. So the guitar is strapped to my leg so I can like dance the Macarena. A particular playing position, I need to put my left leg on this stool. And the first neck of the guitar is completely normal. It's just like the guitar that I had in my hands until now. And if you want, you can play with just one hand. If you have no friends and no social life, you can train to do this, right? But you know why? Because during the pandemic, I needed the other hand to do the COVID test, you know? So, if it comes out negative, then you can finally proceed and use your right hand again to add a melody to this harmony on the second neck. So you're just gonna do like... You know what you're gonna do first of all? You're gonna plug the cable. So the second neck, essentially, it's thought to play melodies on it. Yes. So as I was saying. And the guitar ring to add some percussion also to all of this. And then there is the third neck, which is the most messed up of all. What is this for? So when you look at the neck, what comes to your mind in the first place?
Bass.
It's a bass, and you're correct. And then what about the number of strings? Three strings, okay? But if you look at the frets, there is something particular, right? Right, so there are two ways of interpreting it. Either it's fretless at the top, so all these frets are the top frets and they're not there, or it's just the other way around. meaning that the first threat is not here, but it's here. Why would this be? So, if we play this, right? We can do it with two hands, of course. Can we do it with one? Yes. So with the other hand, technically, we could have percussion, right? We go like... But if then I want to add another part to this, and I can't, I feel like, okay, can I do what I do with two hands, just with one? Just with one arm? Is it possible to play this bass line and the percussions at the same time with one arm? No. So, why? Because if you wanna play the percussions with this hand, you need to go down there and you cannot possibly play that part. And if you wanna play with this hand the bass line, you need to go up there, so there's too much distance. The only way to solve the problem is to take the neck, to reverse it, to flip it over. So all of a sudden, this part of the neck is here on my side, close to the body. So I can do the same thing. But I'm close enough to the guitar body to also have percussions. And this hand is still free. And you can also play all the necks at the same time. If you do this, for example. And then you extend the finger here. And then you have percussion. Okay, so this is the last song that I'm gonna play for this first set, and then there's gonna be a little intermission. This is Feel Good Inc. by Gorillaz. See you later. This capo, throw it on the ground, take this one, put it back on the guitar, and the guitar should still be in tune, because there's like a modulation in the song, and I'm gonna do it that way. So it's a high risk song. If it works, it's nice, you know. If it doesn't work, then the show is gonna end miserably. I'm just gonna go to the green room in shame, and I'm just gonna walk off without even clapping. But if by any chance it goes well, then please show some love, and if you want to hear one more song, that's the way to do it. So I'm gonna play my version of Sweet Child of Mine. Thank you.
Thank you so much.